All right, good Sunday morning, everybody, live and direct from downtown Memphis, Tennessee. I'm meteorologist Austen Onek. Things are decently quiet for the time being and not really seeing too much of anything to worry about. Got some cloudy skies across the Mid-South area, and we'll continue again to see the possibility of some more of those clouds lingering throughout the course of the rest of the day today. So if you have any plans for outdoors, looks like you can go ahead and keep them, but keep in mind that we are going to be seeing again the possibility of some more scattered showers and thunderstorms. Not a lot, but they will still be possible across much of the area as we go into the rest of the day, so please keep that in mind. And as we get into the rest of the day, again, not really seeing too much of anything to worry about for right now, but we'll continue again to monitor for anything in the way of showers, and you can keep up to date with that on News Channel 3 live on air and also online. We'll give you more details on that coming up in just a little while. Give me just one second here so we can welcome in all of our Facebook viewers and get everybody updated as to what's going on here in the Mid-South area. If you're just joining us, if you've never had a chance to be on here before, first of all, welcome to Weather Overtime. This is our live online video weather blog, well, live at the time, recording it so that everybody can see it a little bit later on today. So if you'd like to know more about what's going on and you have any questions, or there's something on here you would like to see when it comes to weather around the world, more satellite pictures, more radars, more look at climate data, all that type of stuff, whatever it is you're looking for, let us know at austen.onek@wreg.com or find me on all of these, those, or that over there, those icons again showing you where I'm on social media. Tons of weather information, tons of science details. It's all out there, and would love to hear from you to find out more about what it is that you would like to see on here. A lot of clouds across the Mid-South this morning, not a lot going on at this point. Plenty of clouds, yes, but no rainfall to speak of, at least for right now. You can see proof of that on radar, and we'll have Storm Tracker 3S coming up here in just a little bit. So far, we're just not seeing much of anything across the Mid-South where it involves rain. Now, we could see some speckles of rainfall coming up a little bit later on today. We'll talk more about that coming up here in just a little while. Temperatures in the Mid-South, again, fairly calm and pleasant out there, mainly in the mid to upper 50s to round about the lower 60s. We've got 61 degrees at West Memphis at the airport, 55 degrees at Dyersburg so far this morning, 59, a very popular number, Somerville, Fayette County, back toward Hardeman County in Bolivar, 57 degrees in Craighead County in Jonesboro for this morning. Now, that, again, for the temperatures, not doing too bad out there. Visibility in the Mid-South registering 10 miles and continuing again to see some very quiet conditions out there where it comes to fog. Maybe some patchy haze across the area, but just not really seeing all that much of anything. Water vapor satellite showing again the cloud cover in and around portions of the Midwest, and that again being drawn up off the Gulf of Mexico, and that's doing a good job of keeping clouds around and also the possibility of seeing some more chances of light scattered showers coming our way as we get into the rest of the forecast. We'll talk more about that in just a little while. Storm systems back out to the west, and they're trying to make their way here. No question about that, but they are going to be taking a while to get here because of this area of high pressure back to our west, or back to our east, keeping any storms to the west from moving our direction. So we're going to be seeing high pressure and control from New England all the way down to the Gulf of Mexico, but some of those showers and thunderstorms could start to wander a little bit closer to where we are inside that line right there, seeing the possibility of showers and thunderstorms taking place from, say, around the Crescent City up to Kansas City, Midwestern area, picking up better chances of showers and thunderstorms there. Just not really seeing all that much in the way of problems out across the area. Tropics for this morning, the only thing really major league going on is, again, this what's being called a nor'easter off the coast of Florida. If you're heading down that direction, this storm system, it's given a number of Invest 99L making its way up the northeast coast of Florida and could be a problem, again, for travel and might develop into something else into the course of the next several days. So we're going to be watching that again with a lot of interest. We're not going to feature too much from the Hurricane Center at this time because as of right now, we just do not have too much of anything happening. This disturbance off the Florida coast, hardly any chance of it developing into anything. But once again, if you are traveling, this could be something that you really do need to pay attention to. Next few days, high pressure will remain in control, which means all those nice storm systems which could be rolling through here and giving us some rainfall to settle our dust a bit is not going to be happening. Isolated showers and maybe a thunderstorm, yes, but that's going to be about all that we see out there. Good morning to everybody for joining us. into and around the area on Facebook and also on Periscope and Twitter for this morning. So thanks a lot for keeping in track of what's going on with weather with News Channel 3. Drop your location and your weather reports, if you have them this morning, into the comments section. We'd love to see more about what's going on there. Hazardous weather outlook, nothing to be seen over the next several days. It is going to be warm today. Temperatures will be back into the lower to mid 80s across much of the Mid-South, including a few mid to upper 80s down to around Clarksdale and close to Tupelo. Could be some mid to upper 80s there. Low temperatures into tonight, upper 50s to lower 60s, and winds early tomorrow morning out of the southeast at about 5 to 10 miles per hour. So that could be kind of uncomfortable for the kids waiting for the school bus stop tomorrow morning. So please keep that in mind. Chances of rainfall, again, not major, but they still may pop up a shower or two, especially across southwestern parts of the viewing area, south and west of Memphis. That's going to be the main thing that we see out there. High temperature for Monday. We're going to be going back into around the mid to upper 70s to the lower to mid 80s. So once again, if you're just tuning in, again, the forecast for right now, which you can get at WREG.com/weather, it is looking warm and staying that way into the course of the next several days. Highs in the lower to mid 80s. Lows in the lower to mid 60s, a few upper 60s from time to time. And there is that chance again of some showers and thunderstorms out there. Doesn't really look like much, but it will be possible off and on. Best chances coming up by next Saturday. And that again will be the best possibility of a thunderstorm or two as the next storm system rolls on through. That will bring us the possibility of some cooler weather into next week, not this next week. The first week of October, as you can see, looks rather on the warm side for right now, but maybe temperatures around 70 by next Tuesday, so looking pretty good there, and at least cooling off by just a little bit. So if you like the warmer weather, it's going to be sticking around for a while. Catch our 7-day forecast at WREG.com/weather for more. Coming up tonight, not much to be seen out there. A Falcon 9 rocket body will be about the brightest thing in the sky, and with the partly cloudy skies out there, it may be a little difficult to see. It'll be rising in the west, setting in the east at about 7:45 for tonight. It's not going to be all that bright, but it's going to be the brightest thing you can try to spot. More information available from heavensabove.com if you'd like to find out more about what's flying over your area when it comes to satellites and also all kinds of other things about the planets and the stars and constellations. All neat stuff, and you can take a look at that. Plus, tonight at Kennan Observatory at the University of Mississippi, the University of Mississippi Astronomical Department will be holding an open house. That'll be tonight at 7 o'clock at Kennan Observatory on the Ole Miss campus. 7 to 9, they'll be observing double stars, hopefully the planet Neptune, and as much as they can take a look at through the telescopes tonight. It's free to the public. It's great for families to take a look at. So, again, weather permitting, if it's too cloudy, they'll have to cancel, but a great opportunity to introduce your kids to more about what astronomy is all about. And this is one of the really cool astronomical observatories that I've seen since I've been in the Mid-South area. So Ole Miss tonight, University of Mississippi campus in Oxford, and a great opportunity to learn more. And again, that's tonight from 7 to 9 p.m. if you'd like to know a little bit more about that. Robert Williams checking in near Oxford, 8 miles south, 60 degrees. Thank you very much. Gloria Davis, cool in Benton County. Thank you very much for checking in. Facebook now just giving me all this information. Robert Williams, thanks for joining us. Sorry about no power. Julia Cavallo, welcome to the show for this morning. More on my Facebook page, also on my Twitter page as well, and on Instagram, passing 3,000 pictures posted over the last few years. And thanks to everybody for coming along for the ride. And more details, again, on your forecast as we go throughout the course of the next several days. I got to hop back out on set. Coffee's wearing off. Sorry about that. So we can finish up the last of Daybreak, so join me for the rest of the forecast. Melissa Moon's out there ready to wrap things up for news, and we'll have more details about your forecast online and on air with News Channel 3. We will be on the Anytime Channel tonight at 5:30 because of NFL football, so dial us up online or watch on cable or satellite for the Anytime Channel, and we'll be on probably on the late edition of News Channel 3 at 10 late this evening as well. Live and direct from downtown Memphis, Tennessee, I'm meteorologist Austen Onek. Thanks for joining us for the latest edition of News Channel 3. Exclusive video, weather blog, weather overtime, and stay tuned for more with News Channel 3 throughout the rest of the weekend.